It's also the one of the reasons why you should get angel investors when you first started out, because angel investors, most of them are serial entrepreneurs themselves, and they have a lot of experience in terms of business. Lack of collaterals, like assets, like properties, equipment, machines. If you do not have anything, and you do not have a strong guarantor, most likely your loan is not going to get approved. Right now, in the current market, even an unsecured loan is going to be backed by a personal guarantee, by a strong guarantor or the director themselves. So if you do not have that financial standing, you need to look for someone who has this financial standing to act as a guarantor. Okay, I'm going to touch more on the micro environment, like overexposure to certain industry. If a banks, they have loaned too much to certain industries, then they are not going to lend too much to the other smaller companies. Okay, because they want to manage their risk, they do not want to overexpose themselves, giving out too much loans in a certain industry. Poor economic environment, changes to rules and regulations. In Singapore, the property market always encounters a lot of changes in rules and regulations. That's why this is going to affect a lot in the property market. But of course, given the working capital loan that the government is giving is going to extend until the end of the year. If next year they are going to withdraw this, then it's going to get much harder in a way to actually get more financing, because government is actually subsidizing 50%. You know, if the government is not picking up the risk and the banks have to take up 100% risk, it's only going to get more difficult. Timing. We will never be able to time the market, so a lot of times business owners only ask for financing when they feel that they require the financing, and most of the time that is not the best timing. What is the best timing? In business, it's always good to actually have sales forecast. You should forecast for new business, just start up, you should forecast every month. For 2 to 3 years, then you should forecast at least quarterly. Why you should forecast? Because when you forecast, you are going to anticipate when you are going to need money. You are able to get the financing when your financial statements and bank statements still looks good. And it gives you a higher chance of getting this financing, rather than you are waiting until the last minute and your financials don't look good, your bank statements don't look good. So when all this comes into place, you are 100% not going to get any financing, or you are not going to get the amount that you are going to need for your business. Poor credit ratings, just now I have said before, and also I'd like to add on unfavorable entity structure. What do I mean by unfavorable entity structure? What I mean is sole proprietor, partnership is not going to sit well in terms of banks and FIs. Why? Because they do not know how much you're going to put in. They do not know how much is your money. They want to know how much you're going to put in, how much do you think your business is worth. So for a business, when you set up a business, it's best that it is in a private limited structure, and your paid up capital should be around ranging at least 50,000 to maybe 100,000. That's the best amount, or I would say that's the minimum requirement amount. Actually, there's a lot of business out there that is like $1-$2 kind of payout capital. The banks are not really going to finance this kind of business, because if this is how you value your business, $1 to $2, then they don't really see a need to actually help you in building up this business, because you don't see the prospect in your business as well. Okay, poor cash flow management. Some business, they over leverage. So these are the kind of business that the banks and FIs will not touch, because they do not want to end up with the blade in their hands. Okay, like they are catching the falling knives. They do not want that. But I do know of licensed money lenders, what they like to do is they will still lend to the borrower regardless of how many, or not really regardless, they will check how many money lenders that they have actually gotten a loan before. If they have only gotten one licensed money lender or two, they will consider still lend to this borrower. But if they are the fourth or fifth, they are not going to jump in, because they do not want to be the last one to catch the falling knives. Okay, your poor ratios and no proper accounting. This one is more for sole proprietors. A lot of sole proprietors, because when they submit for their tax reporting, they are only going to report a four-line statement. So a lot of them actually do not actually keep proper accounting. It is very important that you keep proper accounting, because even for sole proprietor, they can grow until it's very substantial, it's big. But if they want to sell off their business and they do not have their proper accounting, then they are not going to get the value that they are looking at. Poor management team. Most of them I mentioned just now, little or no experience in that industry, little or no experience in management, and did not demonstrate capability in business. And most importantly, they are involved in litigation, especially if it involves maybe like cheating, or they are not fulfilling the contract and other people are suing, other business is suing this company for it. So a lot of time you need to submit your business profile, and your business profile will actually say how much experience you have, what are the kind of customers you have, and what are the like market share you have in the industry itself. So if you do not have a strong business profile, then you are not going to get the loan. Okay, lack of collaterals. Okay, invoices with established business, contracts, equipments, properties, and even investment like shares, bonds, and ULs. UL is also a very good investment property investment for business owners, because UL themselves, you can actually get a loan from the ULs, or even you can use the UL as a collateral to get financing as well. And for secured lending, which is with collateral, generally their interest is much lower compared to those without any collateral. So improvements to be implemented. Okay, you should have a good entity. It's best to at least have a private limited setup with at least 50 to 60 thousand in paid-up capital. And anyway, the paid-up capital is you can use them for your business operate as a working capital and for your business expenses. So you should have at least 1 year to 18 months of working capital. So you should have a good paid up capital for your business. Maintain good accounting standards. I do know that most of the business owner might think that, I have not reached 10 million or I have not reached 5 million. I do not think I need to be audited. So I just do my own accounting. And even though I have no knowledge in accounting, and they will just submit whatever that they have. But if your accounts has been audited, it sits well in the eyes of the credit approval in the banks. So it's best that you at least have a proper accounting. Like I said, have a quarterly or half yearly review of your own cash flow so that you can get financing early. Of course, they have their turnaround period and you do not want to be getting the cash last minute, and if the approval is not there and you're not getting your financing, you don't really have a choice. I always like having choices, and if you do not have a choice, you are going to end up borrowing from undesirable sources that charge you 2%, 1.5% per month, and it's going to hurt your own business. So you have to make your money work harder for you. Like I said, you should have working capital that lasts you 12 to 18 months. The rest of the capital that outside that is more than this 18 months, you should really consider doing investments with your business. Certain investment actually help you to reduce tax as well. So you should consider making your money working harder for you. Okay, so review your revenue forecast quarterly and monthly for young companies. No late payment to the banks, please, because it's going to reflect in your credit report, and the banks, every now and then, if you have gotten financing from them, they will actually do a periodic checks to get checks to check on your repayment to banks, to them, and also to other banks as well. So if they do not like what they see, they are going to request to terminate your credit facility, or even telling you or reduce the amount that they have given to you. I have clients who do not do well after the economy crisis, you know, during the 2007-2008, and they have late payments. Immediately, the other banks asked to reduce their credit facilities by half. So if you do not want these kind of things that happen to you, please no late payment. Plan your financing application early. Increase your company net worth and paid-up capital. If your paid-up capital is maybe 10,000 or 15,000, maybe if you really want, you should increase your paid-up capital, because it's not only about you want to get financing from this banks or FIs, but also to the investors. When you plan your exit strategies, those people who are going to do a valuation on your business, how much capital you have put in, how much is your company net worth, is going to matter a lot on how much they will be paying you for your business. Maintain a set of accounts for financing application. Okay? Important ratios. You need to know quick ratios, debt to asset ratios, and debt service coverage ratios. These are very important ratios. Later, I'll go through with you on a case study on how to actually use these ratios to help you to see whether your business is doing well. Okay, just a formula for the quick ratios, and preferably you should have one or less than 1.5. Why less than 1.5? This one, for one, it actually means that you have a working capital of like 12 months, and 1.5 is 18 months. So if you have more than this, you're fine actually. But the excess cash or equivalents are not generating enough income for you. So it indicates that you actually have the ability to pay your debt in full. But also, if you had a too high amount over here, your ratio numbers is too high, it also means that you have a lot of money sitting around doing nothing for you. Okay. Of course, you have short-term investment. If you're using the below short-term investment, then there's also other long-term investment that you should actually consider rather than just short-term investment. Debt to asset ratio. Preferably, it should be less than 0.5. Because if you get anything that is higher, then you are going to have difficulties in your cash flow. Okay, debt service coverage ratio. Okay, it actually indicates the ability to make your monthly repayment, principal plus interest, of course. And the banks look at this, and to them, this is very important. Okay, they want, when banks assess your loan, they are going to look at your repayment capability. Sure, if your business can scale, good, but the first thing that they are going to, is going to affect your application is, do you have enough to make the monthly repayment? Okay, so the higher the better, best kept above 5. Okay, lastly, I'm going to go through this case study. This one belongs to one of my clients. Okay, and yes, you can see here. Okay, we are going to do the quick ratio. Quick ratio is the current assets. Okay, so this is their balance sheet. Okay, the current assets at 30 million and current liabilities at 31 million. Okay, net current assets give you 13. Looks good, right? I mean, you have assets in millions, you have more than the current liabilities, but it's actually not doing so well if you use it, if you use all the ratios. Okay, your net current at 30 million and 21 million. When we go back, okay, preferably higher than 1 and less than 1.5. Okay, so you look at their stock, it's 9 million. Okay, and their net current assets, I need to minus off this 9 million, so I got a 21 million. Or even less than 21 million compared to 21 million in current liabilities. That means they got a quick ratio of less than 1, which is not very safe. Okay, next we are going to look at this debt to asset ratio. Their total debt and total assets. It's looking not very good, you know, it's not more, is total debt over the total assets is actually higher than 0.5. okay, it's like 66% close to. And of course this debt service coverage ratio, as you can see, the interest payment in the profit and P&L, interest expenses alone 1.3 million. So all in all, although they are making profits, a lot of business owners like to think that as long as they are making profit, their cash flow is good, but not in this case. Their revenue is close to 50 million and they got net profit of 2.3 million and yet their cash flow is not doing well. Okay, so these are the things that you all should look out for, and there are various methods in trying to reduce all these expenses, and I will cover this in at another time. Okay, so if you all have any questions, you all can ask me and I'll try my best to actually answer your question. Thank you.